So the theory of abiogenesis was discarded by Francis Coe Reddy, and he proposed another theory, or he, along with the Huxley and Harvey, proposed another theory, that is theory of biogenesis. And along with Huxley and Harvey, in this theory of biogenesis, stated a statement, omnis vivum ex vivo. Theory of biogenesis given by Huxley and Harvey, and they stated that omnis vivum ex vivo means that life originated from the pre-existing life only. Pre-existing life. Life originated from the pre-existing life, and the theory of abiogenesis was experimentally discarded by three scientists: Francisco Reddy, Spallanzani, and Louis Pasteur. These three scientists experimentally discarded the theory of abiogenesis. What they did, they performed an experiment, and in their experiment, they used the nutrient broth. What nutrient broth was used by Francisco Reddy? He used boiled or cooked meat. He used boiled or cooked meat as a nutrient medium, and Spallanzani also used meat broth, and Louis Pasteur used sugar syrup and yeast extract. So what was the experiment which was performed by Francisco Reddy first? He took 3 glass jars. He took 3 glass jars in which one was covered by parchment membrane, the second one was covered by muslin cloth, and the third one was kept open. The third one was kept open, and he put his boiled meat in this flask, and he started observing this for few days. And after few days, what he observed that the two glass jars, which were covered by parchment membrane and another one by muslin cloths, no other maggots or anything, flies and all these things were present in both these jars. And another one, that the jar which was kept open, he observed some of the larvae of the flies and the maggots roaming around this piece of the meat. So what he concluded that the life can be arised, or the life has been arised from the pre-existing life only. The life, the new flies, has been arised from the pre-existing flies of the larva of the pre-existing flies. And here there was no chance, or there was no space for the flies to enter, so they were unable to lay their eggs and larva, so they are free from the new life, and here the new life has been arised. The similar type of experiment was performed by Spallanzani. He took meat broth, and he took that meat broth in two containers, and one container he kept open, and another one was again covered by that parchment membrane. After few days, he also observed the same thing, that the container which was kept open, he found the new flies roaming around the piece of the meat, and the container which was closed was as it is. He didn't find any kind of life in the closed container. So the next experiment was performed by Louis Pasteur. His experiment is also called as swan neck experiment. Why? Because here both the scientist has taken a round bottom flask, but Louis Pasteur has taken a swan neck flask. Yeah, we'll look after this experiment. That he took one round bottom flask with narrow tube like neck present in it, and he put his sugar syrup and yeast extract in it. Sugar syrup plus yeast extract, and he heated up this narrow tube. So when he started heating up this narrow tube, this tube converted into, or this tube molded into this shape. After heating, the shape of the tube become like this. Now he covered this tube neck, or the, he covered this mouth of the tube by paper, and what he observed that when this tube was covered, he didn't find any of the organism to enter into this tube, or he didn't find any of the life roaming around the sugar syrup and the yeast extract. But when he broken up this tube from here, when he broke this tube, so all the life, or the small organism, find a way to enter into this tube, and they started roaming around this sugar syrup and the yeast extract. So what he concluded, that the life has been originated from the pre-existing life only. There is no such circumstances present in the apparatus we are taking, or in the nutrient medium we are taking. There is no such things in this nutrient medium and all these things which are capable of producing a new life. It is only the pre-existing life which can produce the new life. So this was all about the Louis Pasteur experiment and the theory of biogenesis. Now next theory. Fourth one, theory of catastrophism. This theory states that there were life, or there were some creatures of the life which were present earlier. पहले कुछ लाइफ के क्रिएचर्स प्रेजेंट थे, बट ड्यू टू सम जियोग्राफिकल डिस्टर्बेंसेस और ड्यू टू द कैटेस्ट्रोफ, कैटेस्ट्रोफ मीन्स द डिजास्टर, ड्यू टू द कैटेस्ट्रोफ और बाय द डिजास्टर दैट लाइफ फॉर्म विच वर प्रेजेंट अर्लियर दैट ऑल वर डिस्ट्रॉयड एंड अ न्यू लाइफ हैज बीन फॉर्म्ड. सो दिस वॉज द थियोरी ऑफ कैटेस्ट्रोफिज्म. फिफ्थ, पैनस्पर्मियाटिक थियोरी. पैनस्पर्मियाटिक थियोरी, दिस थियोरी वॉज गिवन बाय अरिनियस. सो व्हाट दे सेड दैट लाइफ हैज कम फ्रॉम सम अदर प्लैनेट और लाइफ हैज कम फ्रॉम द यूनिवर्स. So, and the life has come in the form of the spores. In this spore, some human being like structure was present. This type of structure was present in these spores. And they said that kuch structure, some kind of structure has arrived from the universe to the earth and from and they called that structure as spores. Ki ye spores universe se earth tak aaye and with the breakdown of this spores, jab ye spores toote to ye human being like structure come out from this spores and finding here the fertile soil and the good environment, they started living here only and they evolved as the new life. This was the theory of panspermia. Now sixth one, theory of eternity of life. According to this theory, theory of eternity of life, that life kai saalon se ya kai time se hai, it is present, life has been present on the earth from several years, from generations back, but it has only been changing its form, that life has been present, but it is changing its form from the one form to the another form with respect to the time. But this was totally discarded, that agar life present hai to pehle iske koi proofs kyun nahi hame dikhe, pehle se hame kyun nahi pata chala that it is the one form of life and now it is changing into the another form of life with respect to time. So all these theories were discarded, only the theory accepted was the theory of biogenesis. Now, the last theory, the theory of modern theory, we'll discuss it. The last theory, modern theory, or it is also called as chemogenetic theory, modern theory or chemogenetic theory. This theory was given by two scientists, Oparin and Heldin. There are two phases in this theory. One is chemical phase, or we can call it as one is chemogeny and another one is biogeny. In the chemogeny, we will discuss about the chemical phase of this theory, and in the biogeny, we will discuss about the biological phase, that first life arrived here in the biological phase. Now, let us start with the chemogeny. Chemical phase of modern theory. Chemical phase of the modern theory. This theory was given by Oparin and Heldin. So what chemical phase says that earlier that there was only the atomic phase. All the elements which were arisen, they were only in the atomic form. Like hydrogen, it is only in the atomic form. It has not been converted into its molecular form earlier. So all the elements were in the atomic form. All elements present in atomic form, in the atomic phase. Example, hydrogen. Second, molecular phase. In molecular phase, all the atomic elements or the all the atomic forms that have been generated will converted into the molecular form. Here, the all the atomic elements which are formed in the atomic phase now converted into the molecular form. And here no oxygen was present, no oxygen present in the environment. Due to this, the environment was reducing in nature. No oxygen was present in the environment. Due to this, environment was reducing in the nature. Molecular form mein oxygen present nahi tha. Even if some oxygen has been present, agar kuch oxygen present bhi tha, to wo hydrogen ke saath mein react karke water vapor bana leta tha. So there was no oxygen in that kind of environment, therefore that environment was reducing in the nature. Third, origin of simple inorganic compounds. Origin of simple organic, inorganic compounds. What were the simple or inorganic compounds were formed? Water vapor or water and ammonia. Hydrogen plus atomic oxygen, they will form the water and nitrogen and hydrogen, they will form the ammonia. These were the two inorganic compounds which were formed.